Alright, this is Luke here, just with a quick look at this drum cage that I built. It's a curved front drum cage. At the moment there's no lid or back on it, but it's easy enough to add a lid and a back. Just a couple of quick features on this thing. It was designed to use 2 4-foot by 8-foot sheets of plexiglass. Or better would be Lexan, but I can't get Lexan here. Lexan's more flexible. The front is 3 millimeters thick. The sides are 4 millimeters thick. The front is one uncut piece. I built the whole frame to fit that. And then the sides are half of a piece. So just cut one sheet in half for the sides and it's done. There's a small door in the front to get to the to get to the kick drum mic if you need to, and then it's designed to have a back and lid on it that I just haven't done yet because we haven't put lighting in there. So I'm waiting on getting lighting. Basically, the construction on this was built around the idea of making a channel that would hold plexiglass from 3 layers of thin plywood. So the outer layer and the inside layer are both maybe 1/4-inch plywood. And then the middle layer is whatever thickness you need to accept the plexiglass you use, plus a little spare. So you could just use 1/4-inch for all three and you'd be fine. And then you take some thicker plywood, maybe 1/2-inch plywood, and you cut these flat pieces. And I cut it out. Let me come inside. I cut it out to follow the front so that there's more space here for the kick. But I did that after I built it. So I just did, I figured the front curve that I needed to get my 8 feet in length. And then from there, I cut 4 of those, 1, 2, and then for the top, 3 and 4. And then I actually built the top piece and the bottom piece all as one so that the curves matched exactly. So it was just nailing one layer of plywood at a time onto these curves that I cut out first. Those define the curve for this thing. So you nail and glue or screw and glue the inside layer to those, and then you do the next layer that's going to be the spacer for the plexiglass glued to that and nailed to it. I think I use staples, actually, air nail staples. Then the outer layer, and when you do that middle layer, you hold it, you cut that middle layer shorter so that it creates like a 1/2-inch groove for that to rest in. So rather than having to do any routing or anything, you just cut that middle layer a little bit shorter. And like I said, I built top and bottom as one piece, and then I cut them in half to get the 2 pieces that I needed after it was all glued and dried. So that's just how I did it. Inside, you've got room for, I've got rock wool in these here for sound absorption, or all the way around the top. This is all rock wool inside these pockets. And then in the bottom, same thing, rock wool there on either side of the door, rock wool. So you've got sound absorption. And then the design was to just have 2 4-foot sheets come at a bit of a, come to a bit of a point back here, and those would have rock wool on them, and one would be made into a door that would swing open. Obviously, I'm not giving detailed building instructions here, just an overview real quick. So there's that, and then the lid would be just resting on top here. Be much easier if you didn't cut out a curve on this top piece. If you just left it straight across, it'd be much easier to build the lid. I should have done that, but I didn't. So anyway, so yeah, so you've got 1 8-foot sheet of plexiglass curved across the front, and then you got a 4-foot by 4-foot sheet on this side, and the other half of that sheet, the 4 foot by 4 foot over on that side. All built basically the same way, just the sides are the same as the front with three layers, with the middle layer being maybe, you know, half an inch, 3/4 of an inch shorter. I gave myself a little more room on the top, but it's the same idea, top and bottom. Three layers, the middle layer stops right about here, so that there's room in there. And then the end pieces are just built out of 2x4s. This one's a 2x2. This one is a 2x4 that I clipped the corner on for aesthetics, and then grooved it down this side to accept the plexiglass. And then this was the trickiest one here. I had to cut a groove, an angle groove into the corner to accept the plexiglass there. So that was the trickiest bit to figure out. But then after this piece was cut with the groove on this corner and the groove for the side on the back edge, then after that piece was done and I was happy with it, then I cut it down here to create two pieces. So basically this side is one unit that's built, and then this front is a separate unit, and they just screw together. So the sides and the front are three separate pieces, and I screwed them together right up in here from the back. Okay. Again, you'd need more detailed instructions if you wanted to build this exactly like I did. But just the basic idea of three layers of plywood with the middle layer being a little shorter to create a groove for plexiglass, and designing it so that the front takes a whole sheet uncut and the sides take a half sheet made this really cheap to build and relatively easy to build. And I'm very happy with how it turned out. Again, I still need to add the back and the top to it, but quite happy with how this turned out. Looks great, works great, with even without a back and lid on it, it already works great. But if we fully enclose it, it'll really cut down sound. Lastly, the riser that it's on is separate. So the booth itself is just walls. You could put it on the floor. The riser, all it is two sheets of plywood. The one in the front has the corners clipped. I built it before I had the curved front, so I need to redo this riser so that it matches the curve of the booth, but I haven't done that yet. It's two sheets of plywood, one going across the front, one going across the back. They're held together with nylon straps screwed onto the underside. And then I got this idea off the internet. What's holding them up is buckets. I couldn't even find matching buckets, but it works still. Just a whole bunch of 5-gallon buckets. You screw the lid to the bottom of the platform and just snap the bucket in. So you can, this riser is portable. You can just flip it over, unsnap the buckets from the lids. The lids stay attached to the riser, and you stack the buckets up and off you go. That works really good too. That's cheap and easy. Two sheets of plywood and maybe 10 or 15 buckets. And you're good to go. Less than 10 or 15, I think I used, it's maybe 6 in the back. 5 or 6 in the front. So anyway, there we go. Just a quick overview, not designed to be a complete build tutorial. Just introducing the idea of this curved front drum booth that uses two sheets of plexiglass. Cost, basically two sheets of plexiglass. Mine cost about $100 a sheet here. A couple of sheets, maybe 4 sheets of 1/4-inch plywood, and then a couple of sheets of thicker plywood for the curves that you run, the little stringers was what I called them, that would sit behind these curves, kind of define the curve. I came in under $500 for all of this. I think I'm actually under $400 right now, but I still have to do the sides and the back and the top. So I figure about $500 when I'm all done. There you go.